There is actually paint going up on the walls, which I am so excited about.
Layla has to follow me room to room. She's like my emotional support animal.
And more than anything, I'm just blown away by the support of our church. I cannot get over like all the people giving up their time. There was people cleaning our house. There was people painting and being there all day. And I just have never received such amazing love and support like that. I mean, hello everybody, good morning and welcome to another daily vlog. My name is Jess. I vlog every single day over here on my YouTube channel. We're vlogging the move, y'all. We're vlogging the moving process. I can't wait till I can start a vlog and not look like a hot mess express. I used to get ready for the day, y'all. I used to start off the vlogs looking really put together, but it's not been happening lately because we're in the middle of a move. Today, we are now 6 days away from moving. This time next week, we will not be here. This house will be empty, which is terrifying to me because I have so much to do, but we're gonna get there. David is in our home in Arkansas today. There is actually paint going up on the walls, which I am so excited about. We have so much help. I have a really hard time asking and accepting help from others, and it like blows me away what people are like going out of their way to just bless us with their time and their energy. I just feel like unworthy of it. I feel like really overwhelmed by it, and it has just been amazing to see God's blessing like put into action in our lives. And he's there and there's people painting and everything, and I cannot wait to see our house. I have not been in the house yet, y'all know this, and I just cannot believe the first time I'm gonna see it. It's gonna look all pretty with the new paint and all of that. So my job, since David is handling all the stuff in Arkansas, I'm here on the home front finishing packing. And I will tell y'all, I feel like I have packed for 3 years at this point. We have been packing since February. It is now the end of April. So we started packing before we put our house on the market. House went in the market around March 1st, I think, first week of March, around that. And, you know, we've kind of done it in waves because we've had to live here. So we don't want to pack, obviously, everything. We've just done like the first round was like obvious, like decorations and mementos and Christmas stuff and random stuff and all that. And then we've kind of gone deeper. I've gone through every single room in our house packing probably at least 5 times. Now we're on the last stretch. So it feels good, but I'm also kind of done. Like, I'm tired of touching everything in our house. I'm tired of like handling things. I want to like get a dump truck and just like throw it all away. That's where I am right now. I'm not going to do that, but I'm kind of getting closer and closer to that. So today it's already like 11 o'clock. I've been working for the last hour or so, and I honestly just want to just sit down, but I'm going to keep the momentum going. And then I'll sit down and edit in a little while because I didn't get yesterday's video edited. My goal today is to clear the closets. And I think this is a good idea, but I'm also kind of nervous about it because it's making more clutter in the floor. I just feel like getting everything out of the closets will help me to be like, okay, the closets are clear, you know? So let me show you. I've got Lucy. Lucy doesn't have a closet, so I did her dresser. Her dresser is totally clear. But it's the same kind of concept, getting their clothes out and kind of sorting them. What I did was I sorted them into boxes, and I'm just going to leave the box open. I wrote a little label on it. I'll show y'all. And for the next week, instead of living out of suitcase, we're going to live out of boxes. We don't have a lot of small suitcases, and the only one we have is like really big, and I just feel like it would get tumbled around, you know, people trying to find stuff. So what's good about the boxes is I can pull them out, a few outfits, when we get done, like on Friday or Thursday night, I could pull out a few outfits and then tape the boxes up. They can move and we'll be able to have clothes, you know, until we get things unpacked. So Mark's closet is done except for some lotion in the, but I've got to figure out what to do with that. All right, let me turn the camera on and kind of show you what I'm talking about. All right, so I still got to move. There's lotion, eczema cream, a clipper, and a ball. So once I get that out, his closet is totally empty. So over here, I'm going to put this in a box as soon as I get one big enough, but it's just a bunch of hangers. I don't even know if we need this many, because Mark is really the only one that still uses kid baby size hangers. And then I just have these boxes that say
you know, what's in the box. And when I get him dressed, it's already pared way down. Like, this is all of his clothes besides what's in the washer, which is just like an outfit or two. So we've already pared down a lot, but this is helpful. And I still have a long way to go in Nate's closet, so I'm going to show you that in a minute. And that's kind of what I'm going to start working on now. The other kind of frustrating thing is I have lost, I think I have another roll of tape somewhere in this house. I have looked everywhere I can think of to look, and I can't find it. And I'm down to like this much tape. And I can't pack without tape because I have to tape the boxes together and everything. I don't want to take all these kids to Walmart. I also don't want to do a grocery pickup and have to wait for hours, you know. So I don't know what I'm going to do. I canceled my grocery delivery because I just was feeling like it was kind of expensive with a tip and all of that. And we weren't using it that much. So I canceled just the free trial I had. So I can't get it delivered. I know we could probably DoorDash it from somewhere, but I just don't want to have to spend that extra money. I don't know. But we may have to run to Walmart, which I am not looking forward to on a Saturday with three kids. But we'll see. I may just get to a stopping point and handle that later. I don't know. But let me show you the state of Nate's room. I've purposely not done a lot in his room because I don't want to freak him out. He came in here and saw me doing marks and he got a little bit upset. But it's like we're down to, we're going to have to slowly start doing his room. So let me walk you guys in there and show you like the state of
things. I just want to say, if you are not a fan of moving content, I am so sorry. I truly just vlog what our life is like. And right now our life is a lot of this. I have taken out probably at least half of his clothes and already boxed them up. But there is still all of this. So my goal is to get all of this cleared out. I've already cleared off this so I can move that to the garage. I want to be able to move that to the garage. And I'm not going to touch his books for the next couple days, and then we'll start packing those up. So once I get these cleared off, I can dust them, move them over. I'm packing up the least little bit, or the last little bit of toys that the kids aren't really playing with. The living room is full of toys. I'm just letting them kind of destroy in there while I work in here. But anyway, that's the update of the day, and I'll let you guys know how it goes. I'm just so over it, y'all. I'm so ready to be done. But Nate, obviously, like, he has to sleep with all of those books. I don't know how he does it, but he just loves his books so much. And I know if I pack them up too early, he's going to be upset. So we're going to try to work around the books. Layla has to follow me room to room. She's like my emotional support animal. And she like feels the stress and she just comes and hangs out with me. I mean, I wish everyone could have a best friend like Layla because she's amazing. Yes, you are your mama's buddy, aren't you? She literally follows me room to room. So how could you not love that? I love you, girl.
It's only been like a second since I last talked to y'all, but David is just sending me video of everyone painting, which again is just blowing me away how much they're blessing us. But y'all, the paint looks so good. It looks so good. So the walls, I'll have to try to show you guys before pictures eventually. The walls were like a yellowish beige, like a very yellow undertone. That's not the reason we're painting it. It would have been fine. It was kind of a neutralish color, but the walls were in such bad shape. There was so much just dings and smears and smudges and dirt and all kinds of stuff. So I'm so glad we're getting them painted. So much had to be spackled. They had like lights above all of the bedrooms, like rope lights. And when they took them down, like it pulled a bunch of paint off. It was just, it's been a nightmare. And these people have spackled and like given their blood, sweat, and tears to our house. And I'm just like amazed. But he just sent me the video of them painting and it looks like a different house. It looks so good. I'm so excited. So we went with the Sherwin-Williams color, Agreeable Gray. I know that's a super popular color. Every time I tell someone, they're like, oh my gosh, I have that color. It's just a really good grayish. It's not really super gray. It's not super beige. It's like a good light. It's not really even light gray. It's just, it's a very unique color. It's just a very... sometimes when you paint walls white, it's just stark, you know, and this is just such a homey, nice color. It's going to look so good. And he's like, you know, of course, once it dries, it's going to look even better. Because I was like, at first it was looking kind of white and
as they painted more, oh my gosh, I can totally see the difference. Anyway, I just had to say, yay!
All right, you guys, are y'all ready for this? Dun, dun, dun. It's completely empty. I'm sweating. I need to, like, sit down for a minute. I just hauled that piece of furniture and that piece of furniture to the garage. Really try not to hurt myself, but at the same time, things have to get done. So, Nate's clothes are in, like, a bunch of different boxes. He has way more out than the other kids just because of his sensory needs. He goes through a lot of clothes, and I don't want to pack up too many. So, I tried to write what's on here, so if he needs to get dressed, he can read. And I want to make sure he can see each label. I need to, like, scoot this back a little bit so he can see that. But anyway, I think we're getting there, y'all. We are getting there. I'm officially out of tape. So, I know you can, like, crisscross the boxes, you know, to kind of make them not super secure, but, you know, how you do without tape. So if there's stuff I can pack and I'm not worried about that, like, breaking through or something, I might could do that. I really don't want to go to the store right now. I'm just exhausted. It's right at noon, so I'm going to get the kids lunch. I'm going to sit down and relax for a little while, but we've made very good progress. We got all of the kids' closets and Lucy's dresser done. So Nate was not very happy. When he saw me moving this out, the big closet organizer, he kept trying to push it back in. Bless his heart. But I think it's good for him to see, you know. So, all right. That's done.
All right, you guys. It is now like 6:30. So, we did have like a little break, a little quiet time. It did not last very long. It was very short. Mark only laid in his bed for like 30 minutes. But he fell asleep just about an hour ago on the couch. I took a little video, and I woke him up after about 30 minutes because I wanted him to sleep tonight, and he is so grouchy. So we're dealing with that. I made the boys some French fries and Nate some chicken nuggets. Mark's having some like Greek yogurt with it because he won't eat chicken nuggets. I've gotten so much work done today. I'm sorry, I'm still coughing. I packed up a lot more at the pantry. I packed up more stuff in our closet. Like, I had some jewelry organizers and random hats, winter hats and purses and stuff like that. So I packed all that up. Lucy found my extra roll of tape, so she saved the day with the tape. I'm probably still going to have to go buy more. I don't know why I keep buying like two little rolls at a time. I keep thinking like, oh, surely this will be enough. And I've done that like three or four times now. But they don't have a bigger package. I used to buy my tape in like a dozen. And I haven't been able to find that. When I was doing paparazzi, I bought it on Amazon. But obviously, I don't need that much tape all the time. And so, anyway, I need to just, probably though, one more will be enough. Because we're getting down to the wire. I need to edit the video for tomorrow. I still haven't done that. I've just been busy packing. The church family has knocked the painting out. Y'all, the house is almost completely painted. I am just shocked, shooketh, what the kids say. I don't know. It's just amazing to see how fast they got that stuff done. And David just texted me that our fridge is just now, he showed me a picture of them loading the truck, unloading the fridge off the truck. And I'm just waiting. I'm praying to God this fridge fits. It's going to be tight. It could go either way. We did measure it and all that, but still there's not much wiggle room. Like there is, it's either going to fit perfectly or it's going to be too, there's not going to be enough wiggle room. So I'm hoping this fridge fits. I haven't heard anything in about 30 minutes, which I feel like, is that a good thing or a bad thing? I don't know. He said right now they're just going through and doing a second coat on any areas that need it. And they're touching up a few things. I'm just like blown away. So anyway, I just wanted to update you guys on how everything was going. Mark is in there whining. I can hear him. And I keep saying, what's wrong? What's wrong, buddy? And he's just like, I'm sad.
I know you are. I'm sorry. But he's very tired. I wish he would have taken a little nap, but it did not. He didn't even lay down for longer than like 30 minutes. So anyway, Nate has done very well. I even packed up a bunch of his, not a bunch. I packed up all of his Mo Willems books, which he goes through phases with the books. And right now he's in a big, big Nate phase. So he hasn't been reading the Mo Willems. So I thought, well, I could pack those up. I don't know that he's noticed yet. So I'm hoping, I figure if I just do a little bit at a time and just like ease into the books being packed, maybe that'll be better. I don't know. But anyway, I am going to figure out what Lucy wants. She's just getting out of the bath. So if I figure out what she wants for dinner, I don't know what I'm going to have. I've just kind of snacked all day. I'm like such an emotional eater. I need to get back to my intermittent fasting. But when I am stressed, and I am like ultimate, like I am so stressed right now, just like, it's not even, I don't even know what it is. Moving is stressful. Okay. That's what it is. Moving is stressful. It's chaos. It's stressful. And, like I just like stuff food in my mouth all day. Cause I don't know why it's a problem. So anyway, I am going to get some more stuff done and I'll catch up with you guys in a little bit.
You guys, I just literally talked for like 6 or 7 minutes, told y'all all kinds of stuff, and accidentally just deleted the footage. Yeah, I hate when I do that. I just got done editing. This is so late for me to get done editing for tomorrow's vlog. And I was like, oh, let me clear the memory card. I just started deleting, like, not even realizing I'm deleting today's footage. Okay, so let me try to remember what I was telling y'all. I just put the kids to bed. Our refrigerator situation. Okay, so we still think it would fit in the hole, but when they got the fridge in our kitchen, it wouldn't fit past the island of our kitchen. So there were some people from church there who are construction people. Like, they know what they're doing more than we do, because we have no idea. And they were like, we can take the doors off. It's fine. We'll hook it up for you. We will get it in this hole. So the Lowe's people are like, we can't be a part of this. So they left. Well, before they even touched trying to take the doors off, they just took the plastic wrap off the fridge, and there was a big scratch down the thing, which of course we don't want that. I mean, we just paid full price for this fridge. So David said there's a dent and a scratch, and it's not anything anybody did. It just came that way. They hadn't even touched the fridge. So because the Lowe's people already left, we've got a, David already called Lowe's. He got them to like schedule a return or something. I don't know how much of a pain in the butt it's going to be to return this fridge. Right now it's sitting in our living room. so it was the last fridge of that kind, of course. But now that we know that it's going to be kind of a pain to install, we're wondering if we should get a, it's not even the width, it's the depth that we have to worry about with the island. So they have other depths. There's counter depth, which is shorter, and then there's standard depth. This was a standard depth fridge. So if we got a counter depth, it would fit better past the island. This may be totally boring, but that's what happened. And so we're back to the drawing board with the refrigerators. Dave was going to actually go. I found some online that are pretty comparable. They're not going to be as deep, so I'm not going to be able to fit as much stuff in there. But we are going to have a backup fridge. We have a backup freezer, so I think we'll be fine. and that way we won't have to like worry about taking the fridge apart to try to get it in. So I'm so tired of the fridge situation. We spent days on the first fridge, days, and it was a pain in the butt to get the fridge scheduled and delivered, and now we've got to deal with the return, which I have not had good experiences with Lowe's. I would not keep going with them, except the fridges are so much cheaper, but the customer service has been horrible. So anyway, on better news, our entire house is now painted. They got that done in like one day. Now, there was people from the church there a couple days before, like taping, spackling. And then today there was so many people there painting. It looks so good, y'all. The paint has made a world of difference in that house. It looks like a new house. Like every time David shows me pictures or FaceTimes me, I am blown away. And more than anything, I'm just blown away by the support of our church. I cannot get over like all the people giving up their time. There was people cleaning our house. There was people painting and being there all day. And I just have never received such amazing love and support like that. I mean, it's humbling. It's hard for me to accept because I'm not there to help. I just feel like guilty almost. But we are just so excited, and it really did help. I feel like this is God's way of like showing me that it's all going to be okay. Like, he is moving us, and if he's moving us, he's moving us to an amazing church family, an amazing job for David, an amazing house. Like, he's got all the details, and I really felt a lot of the sadness dissipate today, which I am so thankful for, because I've really struggled. And I'm still probably going to be sad when I leave this house, because I did love this house, but we are going towards a church family that I have never seen such love and acceptance and support, and I am just amazed. I'm amazed. So, such a great day. I got a lot done here. I don't know why my neck is all red. I was scratching it probably. I've got so much work done here. I've done so much packing. We still have a lot to do, but it's coming together. I just made some dinner, so I'm gonna go eat that. I'm trying to use up stuff. I just got the kids to bed. It's a very late dinner for me. I made a pastaroni box. It's like angel hair garlic pasta, which I used to live on that stuff in college. So it brings back lots of memories, but I had one that the box is kind of crushed. I didn't even feel like it would be a good thing to move. It would be like demolished in the move. So I made that, and then I cooked some meatballs in the air fryer. I have a bag of frozen meatballs, and then I'm going to toss the meatballs in the sauce. Sounds really good. So I'm going to go eat that, and then I'm going to bed. But anyway, I cannot believe I had to do this whole thing again. Anyway, I love you guys so much. I hope you have a great day. If you like this video, you know what to do. Go to big thumbs up. Leave me a comment down below. Please subscribe if you're new. I'll see y'all tomorrow.
Been feeling something for you lately, and I am trying so hard to just stay cool.